Hi, Konstantinos. Thank you all, and especially thanks to Konstantinos for organizing such an important conference on such an interesting issue and timely. Just a couple of words about Global Sustain. We're a member-driven organization in corporate responsibility, sustainability, and responsible investing. For those of you who don't know us, we operate now globally. And I've been asked to come here to present the latest updates and trends on the regulatory environment on sustainable finance in Europe and how this is linked to corporate governance. So the European Sustainable Finance Framework, which was introduced just 3 months ago to the market, and it's still on a consultation basis, it's a framework that comes after all these initiatives and standards that you see on this slide, that I don't plan to talk about this. We need one day for each one of them. But this last framework actually incorporates a great deal on responsible investing, environmental, social governance issues to actually both corporates and investors. So I will briefly, in the next 8 minutes, give you an overview of around 700 pages of regulation that I have the pleasure of spending my summer reading. Sustainable finance now has become regulated, and it's going to become regulated in early 2020, because there's still some work needed in the European Union by the technical expert group that has been dealing with this regulation. EU has also devised a hashtag for that, because they wanted to make it so much widespread to the corporate and investment community. But why do we need a regulation for sustainable finance and investing? Because, as you know, the European Union has committed to the Sustainable Development Goals and the Paris Agreement, and there is an investment gap there that's been measured closely to 180 billion euro per year. So the European Commission, even though it has the European Fund for Strategic Initiatives, they also want to mobilize additional capital to finance this gap. So they came up with an action plan. It's called Financing Sustainable Growth last year. And this action plan has 10 precise actions on what the EU is going to do. The first one was this sustainable finance framework. And it's really going to help not only achieve the SDGs for the European Union, but also to satisfy and meet another commitment by the Commission to become completely neutral carbon by 2050. So for the first time in a regulation, we have a definition of what is ESG. So the regulation, which is the source that you can see at the bottom of the slide. And it's also amending several directives that most investors fall in, asset managers, asset owners, and corporations. Defines what is E for the environmental objectives of the corporates and investors. Defines what is S for the social objectives, like contributions to inequality, fostering social cohesion, labor relations, etc. But also defines what is G, the governance part, which is why we're here today. So I'm going to show you like a couple of examples what we mean by ESG. I'm not going to talk about E or S, I'm just going to stick to G. But board independence, things that we've been talking today at this conference, director compensations, we have shareholder voting rights, litigation risks, corruption, bribery policies, codes of conduct, transparency policies, suppliers code, just to name a few. So there are several frameworks out there, initiatives that provide you with factors, issues, and material issues that are pertinent to your organization when it comes to governance. The fun part is that the investors and market participants and insurance companies need to disclose this information publicly in written policies on their websites, how they can address ESG issues into their investment decision-making process. So there's got to be disclosure mechanisms and materials published online. And this will be in a comparable, comprehensive way, so that it's understood to the public, first of all, consumers, investors, and the advisors to the corporations and the investors as well, and of course the regulators. Here are the main objectives of this legislation. The first one is to create a EU classification system of sustainable economic activities, because up till now everyone was saying that I'm environmentally sustainable and I do this and I do that, and how much sustainable are you? Are you 20%, 50%, 100%? So with the introduction of the taxonomy, which is the main document of this framework, now there is a definition for what is sustainable for every economic activity. Up till now, 9 major sectors have been identified, but more are coming. The second one is the disclosure requirements for the investors when it comes to ESG. So from now on, from 2020, every investor that claims that something is sustainable, responsible, social, environmental, whatever, it's got to follow this regulation. Then the Commission is considering benchmarks. Investors follow benchmarks, so these benchmarks need to disclose how ESG criteria are met into their indexes. So you will know which benchmarks follow now responsible investing. Of course, the fourth reason is avoid risk of greenwashing. So everyone now will claim that is X percent compliant with this regulation. And the EU also is planning further policy action, introducing labels, standards, and other things, awards, into the responsible investment arena. The following directives will be amended: the MiFID, which is one of the predominant directives of the investment industry in Europe, and the Insurance Distribution Directive. Just for the completeness of the presentation, which is free, which of course okay to distribute the participants, these are the active links to the regulations, so you can access the regulations directly. And this is the new architecture and design of the financial system in Europe. These are the 5 main documents. It's the taxonomy, and then is an additional document how you use the taxonomy, if you're an investor, whatever, or a corporate, or corporate banking, or retail banking can use a taxonomy, or municipalities can use a taxonomy. States, member states can use it for criteria for investments and incentives. Then you have the benchmarks, another report, how benchmarks should be structured to address ESG issues. And the last one is the corporate disclosures. Nothing can work if companies do not disclose, and companies now are required by the directive on non-financial disclosure. So this is their guide. This is a regulation written by the market for the market. It's not written by bureaucratic clerks sitting in Brussels, but from these organizations that actually move the market. So these people, 200 in total, sat down for 2 years and wrote these thousand pages. So they know what they're talking about, and they made it in such a way that it doesn't distort and distract their business, but it incorporates ESG into mainstream investing. These are the uses of a taxonomy, as I said, could be applied by asset managers, all types of asset managements, UCITS funds, alternative investment funds, portfolio management, private equity, real estate, infrastructure, whatever. Then you have the insurance brokers and insurance firms, corporate investment banking, and last, retail banking. This is the alignment of frameworks. There are 2 predominant frameworks in Europe working on non-financial disclosure as we speak. The first one is the non-financial disclosure, which is the outer box. And the internal box is a new regulation that's been adopted. It's called the Task Force for Climate Financial Related Disclosures. And the central component of the alignment of this framework is governance. So this YG from ESG is the most important component of the responsible investing. Putting it all together, in the center of the alignment is the taxonomy, this 400-page document that you need to refer to see if you're compliant. In the top, you have companies disclosing information based on guidelines. Everyone will check on the right box if these activities are compliant with the taxonomy. At the bottom, you have the financial sector, which uses benchmarks, green bonds and standards, regulation to disclose this information, and all leads to the right hand there, right box, which is European commitment to meet the SDGs and the Paris Agreement, and of course, carbon neutrality in 2050. I'm done. Just a couple of slides to show you that we've been working extensively on sustainable finance the last 3 years with leading organizations, mostly in the United States and in Europe, but also in Greece. Leading asset managers here have started to really appreciate the risk management and governance side of ESG, and they see Generation Alpha in their investments. Two slides more. We do a Berlin event in next week about ESG investments. And on October 4th, we do a sustainability forum here in Athens, where these issues will also be addressed. Thank you very much for your attention.